There are a lot of metals around. You can see copper, brass, steel, aluminium, stainless steel. Yet sometimes I would like to know quite a bit more. As a one example, we ordered a bit of an equipment made of cast alloy. This is an alloy based on nickel. That's a bit of cast alloy. You can see it's black when it's oxidized, yet when it's nice and polished, it really does look like just a chunk of stainless steel. Also, what I wanted to make sure that all the welded joints are made of cast alloy. You can imagine what sort of disaster would it be if two bits of cast alloy are joined with stainless rod. And I looked into some simple way just to verify. The supply is reliable, but I wanted to make sure that we are doing it right. And in practice, you can do reasonably good chemical identification of metal without any chemistry using a multimeter and a soldering iron. Let me start here talking with thermocouples. How does it work? It's basic, but it will be useful. What we have K-type thermocouple, possibly the most widely used thermocouples around. They have two dissimilar metals. They have aluminium alloy and chromium alloy connected, welded in a single point, the point that is measuring temperature. These two wires go into the measuring device. They are connected to copper and measure temperature. We have hot junction and cold junction. If we have a temperature difference between these two, temperature hot minus temperature cold, this generates a voltage difference. And if we know temperature of the cold junction, we typically measure it using some other method, some semiconductor, or just assume it's 20 degrees or 21 degrees. We know the temperature if we know the temperature of the cold junction. If we know what sort of metals, what sort of coefficients, then knowing the voltage, we can calculate the hot temperature. And that's the basic how all these thermocouples work. Yet we can invert that problem the other way around. Let's imagine we control the temperature difference. We measure voltage, but we do not know what are the metals. So we can measure this coefficient, and knowing the coefficient, make a good guess on what sort of metals do we have in contact. Let me show the voltage with the multimeter. I take the thermocouple, connect the leads of the multimeter, and we can have a look at the voltage. 94 minus 94 millivolts. And if I just hold the end with my fingers, you can see voltage goes quite a lot. We are having 0.3 millivolts, 350 microvolts. If I release my fingers, voltage goes down to 70, 40, 30, and so forth. It gets around zero. Why is it around zero? Because our hot junction, the very end, temperature of the hot junction and cold junction, they're very similar. So how can we use our knowledge about thermocouples for identification? We take this sort of schematic. We take soldering iron, put it into a constant temperature, something low to avoid oxidation, 100, 150. As you saw, we are talking about very small voltages, so the higher the temperature difference, the higher the voltage we measure, so it gets more accurate. We have the soldering iron, attach some copper clip to the iron, and we poke into the unknown metal, and we have another connector of the multimeter connected to the cold junction. So we have cold junction and we have hot junction. In practice, of course, it's a bit more difficult because it depends on the material of the soldering iron probe, but here we have hot junction and hot junction, so these effects are pretty much compensated. And we are talking about comparing metal using known materials. So we are using some not table as such to identify the metal, which is possible, but it requires a bit more care. What I want to is to make sure that the metal I have exactly corresponds to the metal I know what it is. So 316 stainless steel, which I know is exactly as the unknown piece of metal. And what is nice here is that we can use local analysis. If we have some welded joint which is nicely polished, you can imagine here we have the hot joint, and somewhere here we have our cold joint. As long as we do not hold the soldering iron long enough, we have temperature difference here, and we still can identify such an inclusion of foreign metal. Let me show an example. I take a soldering iron with a new pointy tip, never used before, so it's nice and clean and hopefully has uniform composition. It's pointy, so I can scratch through the oxides. Now let's have a look what we have. We have the soldering iron with the temperature of 180 stabilized for some time. We have the soldering iron connected to one of the probes of the multimeter, and another probe is just free. What I'm doing now, I'm just holding a bit of stainless steel with the probe and poking the soldering iron. And you can see the reading. About -70 millivolts for a bit of stainless steel. Now let's have a look at the cast alloy, nickel alloy. I'm doing the same. And we have -550. You can see the difference is huge, -50 to -550 microvolts. Let's have a look at other materials. Let's look at copper. Again, we hold copper and press it. We hold. Again, we hold copper and press the soldering iron. You can see -1000 microvolts. Again, huge difference with the steel. Let's look at mild steel. Holding the probe, poking it. 1270 brass. Minus about 740 microvolts. Again, a huge difference. Aluminium. Let's look at aluminium. Then 61 microvolts. So you can see having a few standard materials like cast alloy, stainless 316, and mild steel, I can very precisely identify which metal I have in front of me. So again, stainless, mild steel, 1220 microvolts, 316 stainless, 50 microvolts, and cast alloy is about 550. Can see with a multimeter and the soldering iron, you can differentiate different metals that are significantly different in chemical composition: nickel-based cast alloy, stainless, mild steel, aluminium, bronze, copper, and many other metals. And you do not have to use even such a fancy multimeter with microvolt readings. You can use a standard temperature probe and just plug these readings into the temperature sensor sockets, because the circuitry here is designed to amplify microvolt signals. And of course, you treat it as relative based on your reference materials. So we have localized precise chemical analysis at pretty much no cost at all. Isn't it unimaginable?